So Happy New Year. Happy Friday. Thank you very much for coming to my residence. That we have small group in person here at the residence. And thank you very much for joining us tonight and this morning with the audience online. Thank you very much. And this is a very special Friday Night Live because this is the first of 2022. And this is a year we are overcoming this pandemic. This is the third year. But now the time for us to beat that pandemic. And I think it's a great, great occasion to come together over great music tonight. And actually, we started Friday Night Live October 2020. Then we did it 2020, and we go through from January to December 2021. And this is January 2022. This is the third year of Friday Night Live. And when we started this Friday Night Live, our intention was to support musicians in New York City, mainly Japanese musicians, because most of them lost the opportunity to perform in front of the people. So we do not match power, but the best we could do is to provide the opportunity to perform in front of the people. That was a sort of an idea when we started the Friday Night Live. And that is our intention. That is our intention to support all those musicians here and there. But at the same time, I become to understand that, of course, we are helping them. We are trying to help support them. But at the same time, we are supported by all those musicians who have come here to perform. And all, we are very much supported by the audiences in person and online. Because this Friday Night Live is helping and supporting to fulfill our mission. That is creating bridge between the United States and Japan in many ways. In this case, music. And I'm so grateful to all those the people who come here up to now, the third year of Friday Night Live. And I should refrain from saying my personal thanks, but probably I should mention, I'm leaving next month, because I'm so completing my tenure here. But yeah, I would say I'm leaving, but Friday Night Live will remain, will continue to support musicians. Thank you very much. Then tonight, as you know, you see all the pamphlet, and also you saw all the musicians. And it's a very, very special concert tonight. This is a mixture and the fusion of the Japanese music and the Western music. Tonight's main instrument is shakuhachi. That is a Japanese bamboo flute. And creating the great, great sounds. Sometimes sounds like a human voice. Sometimes birds are tweeting, and sometimes very like a saxophone-like. So it's an amazing instrument. Tonight, the main instrument is shakuhachi, but it will be played solo. And at the same time, and he will play with piano. That is a classical representative of Western music. But shakuhachi and piano will create great fusion between East and West. And also, shakuhachi will come together with koto, which is also another Japanese classical instrument. It's a very rich sound, like more than 20 strings. It's a Japanese harp. And those one instrument, but three different tastes. Shakuhachi solo, shakuhachi with piano, and shakuhachi with koto. So you will never bored. You will be excited with those music. And especially the selection of the song is Harunomi, that is a Sea of Spring. In Japan, the Harunomi, Sea of Spring, is a New Year celebration. If you go to Japan and spending the year end and the New Year's Day, you will listen to this music many, many times. So much so, this is our blood, our DNA of the New Year celebration. So this is suitable occasion for that. So now, I would like to introduce three great musicians. So first, James Nyoraku Schlefer. Please, James. Thank you. James is a native New Yorker. And he's been playing these instruments 40 years. But you were 35 years old, right?
Okay.
But he spent 10 years in Tokyo. He's learning very seriously, not only shakuhachi, but also he plays koto and shamisen. So I feel like he's more like Paul McCartney. He plays bass, guitar, piano, and drums. So James also plays shakuhachi, koto, and shamisen, right? So it's an amazing person. And in Japan, he's awarded as grandmaster. When I say grandmaster in English, not sounds great. But if I say in Japanese, Dai Shihan, that's a great, great honor and degree. And only best and the brightest can get Dai Shihan. He got it. And also, he also has a certificate for master teachers. So Shihan, that tells how great he is. As a shakuhachi player and other instruments players. And he played at Carnegie Hall and many other distinguished venue across the world, Japan and European countries. And also, I want to say this one. He started the shakuhachi dojo, or learning place in New York. The name is Kyoshin An. And Kyoshin An, my interpretation is the place where you become empty or get rid of the anger, frustration, jealous, or anything from your heart. Then you try to be very empty and concentrating things. In this case, music. So Kyoshin An, he's the headmaster of Kyoshin An. That tells something. Mm-hmm. So we really look forward to your performance tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ambassador.
Yeah, thank you. So next, Masayo Ishigure-san. Ishigure-sensei. She is also master of koto and shamisen and other bunch of instruments. But tonight, she will perform koto, and she will support James. And she started those musical instruments at the age of 5 in Gifu Prefecture. So she's been great. Now she's in New York, and actually last year she came over here to perform her own orchestra with koto and shamisen, and so creating the bridge between East and West. And tonight she'll be supporting James. And one thing I want to mention is she was nominated as the one of top 5 female cultural representatives of the Japanese in New York by Prime Minister Abe. So there are a bunch of female performers and artists and others, but she is one of those. Not just one of those, top 5, by Prime Minister Abe. So that tells something. Not only that, Newsweek magazine designated her one of 100 Japanese respected by the world. That means a lot. So we're really looking forward to my performance. Thank you very much. And finally, Kathleen Supové, please. She's a pianist, and according to New York Times, her piano playing is explosion of the piano. It's amazing pianist. And she's like a revolutionary, playing with robot or others. Not just breaking sort of, the boundary of music, boundary of piano, will be destroyed and created new sphere, new dimension. By Kathleen. Thank you very much. And also, I should mention one more thing. Yes, she got the John Cage Award. Mm. That means John Cage is a person who created totally new musical world. So thank you very much. And we're very honored to have you here tonight. And so much so, music will tell for itself. So I will stop here. So thank you very much, and let's have a great time tonight. Thank you very much.
皆さん、明けましておめでとうございます。私はジェームズ・ニョラク・シュナフと申します。よろしくお願いいたします。これから英語で話さなければなりません。
Welcome everyone. Greetings and Happy New Year. I'm thrilled and delighted to be performing here at the residence of Ambassador Yamanouchi from the Consulate General of New York, of Japan in New York. Ambassador, thank you so much for having me. I'm deeply honored. The music you just heard, as Ambassador Yamanouchi said, Haru no Umi, in spite of the seasonal reference in the title, is a New Year's piece in Japan. And it brings the idea of new beginning, new start. We're beginning now, we're gonna start all over again, new year, new springtime has that feeling about it as well. And it was written about 100 years ago by a wonderful koto player and composer named Michio Miyagi, who was sort of groundbreaking in making the koto an instrument that became more known for writing new music and also his innovations on the instrument itself as well. But many of you know that the shakuhachi is actually an instrument that is played was played originally as a form of meditation practice, of Zen Buddhism, of meditation. They would practice these instruments as a way of finding silence and sound coming together and focusing on the sound, focusing on the emptiness of the silence and the combination of the two, and therefore find a path to enlightenment through sound. The Japanese expression, ichi on jobutsu, finding Buddha in one sound, one enlightenment in one sound. And this magical music caught my attention many years ago, and I decided I needed to learn more about this, which is why I began shakuhachi. I'd like to play one of these original tunes for you now. It's called, that music is called Honkyoku, original music of shakuhachi, and it was always played solo. And this is one of a version of a piece that has many versions. The title is Tsuru no Sugimori. It roughly translates nesting cranes or the life of the cranes. It's about the birds, the big birds. And it is one of the few honkyoku pieces that actually has some kind of a story to it. And it's about a male and a female crane who come together. Of course, they mate for life and raise their young, and the young grow up, begin to fly, find their mates. Old cranes grow old and move on to the next life, having fulfilled their purpose on earth. And it also is an allegory to the love, the unconditional love of parent to child that Buddha had for humanity. So it falls into that dual category. So this is Tsuru no Sugimori.
Thank you.
alone. Sorry. Turn this up. There we go. Okay. So thank you very much. That was Tsuru no Sugimori, the Nesting Cranes, solo honkyoku, traditional honkyoku piece. Nobody knows who wrote these traditional pieces. They were really created, and they weren't meant for entertainment, but they are so powerful, and so they speak to the soul. All the sounds of the shakuhachi, all the sounds of the human emotion come through. The next I'd like to play for you is an original version of a classic piece, classic honkyoku, called Sanya. Sanya is a bit of an enigmatic title, literally Three Valleys, but it has a number of interpretations. They think maybe there really was a place, Three Valleys in China, a holy place that people would go to. It also refers to a very state of deep meditation in which you're really unaware of left and right, up and down, just very, very lost in your meditation. And another translation or idea is safe and easy childbirth, meant to ease a woman's labor before she gives birth. So these are the cranes starting a new life, new birth. It's all sort of part of the New Year's idea here today. This, however, is, and many of the Sanya pieces that are prefaced by a place where they're from. For example, we have an Echigo Sanya. Echigo was Niigata Prefecture in the old days. And Futaiken is a temple that's no longer there, Futaiken Sanya. And so I began thinking, well, why shouldn't there be a new Sanya, which is where I'm from, which is Brooklyn, New York? So I made a version which is, to a large extent, true to the original, but also has some of my own New York-y type ideas involved as well. So this is Brooklyn Sanya. Thank you. To introduce and bring up to the stage my good friend and colleague Kathleen Supové to play piano on the next piece, which is a modern-ish piece written in the 1960s, 67 I think actually, although he wrote the year and using the emperor year, so I had to figure it out, but it was I believe 1967, and by Minoru Miki. It's called Aki no Kyoku, which means the they translated autumn fantasy. And Miki was a composer, a wonderful composer, who wrote a great deal of music. He was very prolific, and mixed writing Western classical music, orchestra pieces, operas. He wrote 9 operas, lots of chamber music, and was really one of the first people to really push for getting new music for Japanese instruments. And he started a group called the Ensemble Nipponia that recorded and toured for a long time during the 60s and 1970s. And this is, I think, one of his most beautiful pieces, Aki no Kyoku. It's in 2 sections. The first is very sort of dreamy, impressionistic sounding. And the second brings the tempo up a little bit. And this is Aki no Kyoku. Thank you very much. Thank you. something completely different. So what's a Brooklyn boy like me doing playing the Japanese traditional bamboo flute? People frequently ask, and I, as I mentioned earlier, I just 40 plus years ago, I don't remember exactly when it was, sometime in the late 70s or maybe 80, 81, I really don't remember, I was at a performance at somebody's apartment on the Upper West Side. It was a professor of mine, and he had the students come, this was when I was in grad school, and he would have students come to his house for different recitals. And one time we went, and there was this Sankyoku ensemble, Shamisen, Koto, and Shakuhachi. Now I'm trained as a Western flute player, and played that flute for many, many years. And so I went up to the performer after the little informal concert, and I introduced myself as a flute player. I don't know who it was, they were all Japanese. And I'd never heard any music like this before. It was brand new to me. And I said, wow, I really like the sound of your flute. And he said, and I said, I play the flute too. Oh. And he says, oh, this is a Japanese shakuhachi flute. And I said, oh, thank you very much. And he, you want to try it? And of course, like most people, when they first pick up the shakuhachi, you look at it. I could not make a sound. And I played, I'm a flute player. So I was really frustrated. And eventually I got more and more into it because I found a teacher here in New York and I realized that I liked the sound of this and I love this traditional music. And I just kept going at it. And there you go. 40 years went by and no time. And here I am tonight. So the next piece on the program is an original composition of mine called Duo Number One, not a very exciting title. But it's one of the, it's a, something I wrote a long time ago. And actually Ishigure Sensei and myself premiered it all those years ago. Masayo and I have known each other for nearly 30 years. Dear friend and colleague. and it is, so I noticed that a lot of the traditional shakuhachi repertoire sort of has a slow beginning and a fast middle section and a slow beginning, fast middle section, slow ending. Typical sort of structure. So I decided to write a piece that did the opposite.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much. Thank you, Ishigure-sensei, Kathleen. Thanks so much, you guys. I'd like to finish the program with a short, sort of folk-like solo shakuhachi piece that was composed by a composer slash shakuhachi player in the teens, 20s, 30s in Tokyo, who wrote a number of these little melodies that are honkyoku-like. He even writes honkyoku on them, but they're more melodic than most of the traditional pieces. This one is called the Miyama Higurashi, the sound of the cicadas in the mountains. And if you're there at the right time of year and you, where I live in Brooklyn, in Prospect Park, I can hear the cicadas. but in the mountains, I'm told, is that sort of they start at one end of the valley and then sort of sweep their way across until it becomes this beautiful sound. And so sort of midway through the tune here, he tries to imitate the sound of the cricket, of the cicada as well. So once again, Ambassador Yamanochi, thank you so much, and thank you everybody for having us here tonight. This is an absolute honor and a joy.
Mm-hmm.